So, welcome you all to the stable release of. I think what my intention was to discuss about the topic questions that are open with stable point releases. There's some questions that are obviously open from my point of view, and that is how do we deal with the kernel security updates that have happened in Sarge, but were not included in the last point release, because they need change to the installer, but of course there are a lot of other topics. The second stable release manager, Martin, is also listening to this BOF via video streaming if it works. And I hope that if he has questions or things to say, the Tolima will do it for him. What I would just start with a very short list of what we want to discuss about today, besides of the kernel update installer, which I just note down. So if there are more topics, please tell them to me. And if I'm too fast speaking, please say. So, more topics? Does I? So, anything that comes to your mind now that you want to speak about it? Otherwise, we'll just start with this obviously last topic. So, do you want to start one? So, should I make the introduction of the topic, or from the kernel team, or?
I think you really have to make the introduction.
So what's the issue? I think Franz could do it better, but I could do it as well. But basically, the installer is part of the CDs. And if you change the kernel and we update the UTIPs, there's good reason to do so, but we have to rebuild the installer.
Specifically, if it's an ABI name change, which is what happened here, so the modules are no longer compatible.
Well, you could even leave the old installer UTIPs in stable, but that would mean there is no longer a source version for those UTIPs in stable, which is not something we want to do because of GPL.
And we can prevent the source keeps there.
Yeah, that has been suggested, but that gives you name conflicts, so it's not an obvious solution either.
And we even could just take the current source packages and upload them as a special package somewhere, which ends up anywhere.
Yeah, but that needs a longer preparation than we currently have, probably.
Okay.
Also, it has been discussed before, and basically the outcome of those discussions have been we should update the Debian installer when there is maybe change in the kernel. Unfortunately, having a name change in the kernel UTIPs means that current Debian installer images may break, some of them. Those that are not self-contained, but download kernel UTIPs from the net as part of the installation. So users will have to be warned about that. The main issue at this point in time is that this is the first time we're going to be doing this. So the infrastructure is not in place. And what we basically needed was some extra scripts in the daily package migration setup on the mirror master to allow us to get kernel UTIPs into stable proposed updates. That should be done now.
It is done now.
Is
I checked yesterday evening.
They actually are in stable proposed.
Yes, they are.
Good.
Well, I have to check on the mirrors. I just looked at the keymaster. I'm sorry.
Well, I'll check the mirrors later. Which means that we now could start to build Debian installer using stable proposed updates. And then we need to get the porters of the different architectures to also rebuild the kernel UTIPs for their architecture, which is currently, which requires some coordination, but should be able to undo fairly quickly.
Yeah, and I have all machines except for Spark, which you have, and MIPS-M68K.
Okay.
So, and I know the cons are.
Yeah. Okay, that's great.
something else when uploading packages or proposed updates right now, because currently no package is going to propose updates at all. They are stored in extra queue, and the basic idea is that the stable release team gets access to the queue and can approve packages or reject them, but the approval or rejection part was not done yet. I hope that this is done this week. But until that you can upload, but they won't, you won't get them.
Friends, can you say this is the first time you've done this? First time you've done what? Then you can't understand why this is special.
Do an update of Debian installer in stable.
Right, without going by testing?
Yeah.
Ah, I see. Yeah. And why can't we just do it the normal way?
Because it is a stable update.
Oh, in stable, right.
Yeah.
It's just the point of this. It doesn't mean we are going via testing.
Yeah.
Right.
And the reason we have not had to do it is because the previous kernel updates have been without API changes, which means that the kernel UDEPs were still compatible enough to just ignore it. And
why?
The security issues that were fixed were not that relevant for the installer.
Right.
So we have just skipped that.
We said to bring Sasha 2 out, we said we are just ignoring all the kernel stuff and we'll do it later. And so, basically for R3, our only big topic is the kernel changes plus installer, which is large enough.
So, that's basically the situation. I don't foresee any major problems. We should be able to build the installer using testing proposed updates. The only problem is that we won't be able to test the installer very much. We will basically only be able to do the builds we do ourselves. And after the release has happened and the UDEPs have migrated to stable proper and the CDs have been built, we can then run a check of the installation from CD.
Yeah, but basically, as far as I understand, as far as I guess the situation is stable is, if we do the point release, then we can still test it afterwards to make sure nothing breaks.
Yes.
And it's not so important that we have the installer right at the day of the release.
No, that's correct.
And the old installer, the full CDs will still continue to work.
Yes.
So we can say, okay, we did the point release, the new installer image will appear. In the sleep or whatever, and the full CD system works as an upload solid.
Yes. We will have to communicate this very clearly to our users, so I would suggest using Debian Nouns for this.
I don't have right access to that, other than when I am fine.
No, but we have a member from the.
He also doesn't have right access.
Relations team here who can kind of push it through.
I can try.
I really think we should use that in announce for this.
And I think this should be the very first part of the release update made.
Yeah. And it should also be in a permanent position on the website.
Yeah.
So we have to make sure of that. I don't expect any problems actually with the installer breaking unexpectedly because of this, because, well, the kernel still is basically the same. The kernel itself has been tested and nothing major has changed that would be expected to impact the installer. So from that point of view, I don't really expect problems.
One thing we might note is that Moritz and I are working on another kernel update this week in parallel. It's not an API change,
okay. But
that means there will be yet another kernel image out there when this happens, probably.
Okay. Will that be ready before RC3, or is it targeted for after RC3?
What's the date for RC3?
Well, the date is going to be pushed back because we have not had these kernel UDEPs into stable proposed updates.
Well, if anything goes fine, this flag should be ready by end of that.
Okay.
Well, so I think that should be first then.
Yeah. So I think that means that we can use the current I386 kernel UDEPs and stable proposed updates to do the test build of Debian installer, see how it works. And if the new kernel updates are pushed in, then we should do a rebuild for all architectures, including R386, using those new ones, so we can do the port release with the newest security events. Sounds good to you?
Okay.
One thing I would think is for future API problems that we run into, it would be an idea to put an API version number in the kernel module UDEP. So that basically
they have API. So
then how come we can't add phone to auto detect that your CD is broken, you can't install, so we can at least tell you.
That does happen.
Okay, so yeah. It is clearly already told to the user when they try to do it.
Yeah. If they use an old network image or an old floppy based installation, then they will be told the installer cannot find a kernel UDEP matching the running kernel. Do you want to continue? You're allowed to, but you probably won't ever end up with anything that's remotely useful.
Yeah, I don't know if many users would understand that as much as you need to download a new CD or something.
Perhaps you should change the warning to something like, can't find the kernel UDEPs, please check for newer installer.
Yeah. We could possibly do that.
Of course not with direct.
We
could even do it for Sharks.
Not for Asilo.
Oh, no, we can't do it for Sharks because it wouldn't really mean translation effects, so that's not good.
But it could be something we do for Edge.
Yeah. Please file a wish list bug report against Alma. Okay. Thank you. There's one other issue with the installer, and that's only relevant for Alpha. If you take the base installer UDEP, which is responsible for installing the kernel into the target system, for Alpha that has the API hard-coded into the code, so it will select only the current stable kernel. So with the new update we have to change that to the new API, so it will actually be able to find the kernel to install.
And with PowerPC, it didn't have an API.
Yeah.
When I did this update, I added an API to make the API change. So that would be another.
That's another minor change in kernel Edge, which produces UDEPs. But it's not an issue.
Okay.
It's just the config file of kernel Edge for PowerPC that needs to have the API changes added in line with the kernel name. So that's just one
building. So, Franz, one question, how does it work? Your first update was UDEPs, and then you are building an update installer that goes into by hand, which is then installed by FTP masters?
Yeah, we have to first get all the UDEPs for all architectures interested for some updates. Then I will do, or Joey will do, a build of Debian installer against stable post updates and upload that to stable. That will need by hand processing. Then the auto builders will kick in for the remaining architectures.
Which also will need by hand.
Also will need by hand processing. And basically, then you should be ready for. Release and moving everything to stable.
Okay, and after doing that, the DS will be built from the new installer.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, very good. Okay. So anything more on the DI plus kernel stuff here now? From any of the bulk involved parties or from the indirectly involved people here?
Maybe a question. With the current installer on the Audacy installer came on the Sarge CD, I was very frustrated in trying to figure out how to put together a driver update this way. I had a situation where the installer would not install on the machine that had a different self-range than the kernel installer didn't understand. And I couldn't figure out, and I searched and Googled and everything else, how to construct a driver update. Driver updates are means to insert drivers, modules, into the installer before it boots up, though, you can access drives that may not be accessible otherwise.
Well, we had a very good discussion on that already. For Sarge it's a bit difficult, but we had actually yesterday with security and kernel already a discussion on how we could do it better in the future. Perhaps if anyone of you wants to say something about it.
Moritz proposed yesterday that maybe for Edge we could do something like an Edge and a half, where we add an additional kernel about halfway between Edge and Edge plus one,
okay.
So that we can enable more hardware and do security support for both. Say you talk to the DIT, maybe Franz about this.
Okay. Well, we haven't talked about that yet. Talked about it for Sarge some time ago.
About Sarge.
Our only requirement has been always that the kernel team and the security team would have to be willing to support such kernel.
That was what I'm using as
yeah.
well.
Because otherwise it's just useless to even start thinking about it.
Yeah, and I've been afraid to support two kernels like we're doing now with Sarge.
Yeah.
But the issue there is that 2.4 is old and nobody's really using it.
Mm-hmm.
But if we're doing like an edge and a half, where neither kernel is going to be as old as.
Yeah.
I understand that, but what about what if a user I try to install Edge and I find that it doesn't access the hard drive or something? Can I? Yeah, I need a way to say okay, provide a floppy or a CD that you shove in. So it doesn't have it load either UDEV or something like that prior to trying to do the system install.
We do have support for loading drivers from floppy.
I guess that's not
no. Please, let me finish. In two particular cases only. I think mainly for network. Interface detection. If no network interface is detected,
yeah.
then it will ask for floppy.
I remember that. Okay.
It may also do the same for hard disk, but I don't think so.
No, it didn't, and I couldn't figure out how to create that floppy or how to create
yeah.
what you
well, it's no use creating floppy as there's no mechanism to read from it. So that would possibly need to be added. And the one objection I have to doing it floppy-based is that less and less machines have floppy disks.
Well, how about a CD?
So you would need either to switch CDs, you would need to be able to do it from USB stick, you would need to be able to download it from the network, maybe you would be able to do it from floppy if you have a floppy.
Right.
So that makes for very complicated code.
Okay, now, that does it. I don't know how they do it.
Yeah, so far we haven't tackled it. I think we may do it after the kernel team has done the non-free and the firmware split in the kernel packaging.
Okay.
Because at that point we will need to do something with that.
Okay.
At the moment, I guess the best thing is as a vendor just to up. Presumably they can produce their own installer CD.
Yes, at the moment the best option for vendors is to create custom images. Which for Sarge again is a pain because of the major changes between the 2.6.8 kernel with which the Sarge installer was shipped and the current kernels,
okay.
which have really caused major rewrites of the installer with regard to hardware detection
okay.
and so on.
So for what it's worth, the way I do a lot of stuff for the company I work for is I actually start with DI as is, and I rebuild, I backport patches to current to 2.6.8. Driver updates haven't really been that difficult for us to backport from a recent kernel back to 2.6.8, with a few exceptions. Then I start with that, and I just do the whole build cycle, like runs and the DI team.
So you cut a whole new install CD.
Well, I don't like build every binary again. I replace the bits that I need replaced.
Right, but you have burned the new CDs.
Yes.
Okay. Then unfortunately, I have suggested that to my management, and for some reason, this is a good thing that I'm having, I can push back out. My management tells me that when I try to port the drivers and make that enable them, they don't want me to cut a new installer CD because they claim that we're not in the installer CD business. They only want to do driver update CDs, and that's it, or quickly white paper base.
Well,
that's a good thing for me to push back.
That's a business decision, of course.
Yeah, I know. And now I can push back and see if I can change that business decision.
But we make sure that it's clear that our CD is different, and it, you know, every package in there has a different kernel review name, kernel has an identifier that says it's up by companies.
Right.
So but I can keep, our customers are going to provide the DIT with invalid information and use bug reports.
Okay.
It is something that has to be done very carefully, and it would build things, especially the first time.
Maybe I could approach my management and see if they'd be willing to spend my time to help develop some sort of driver update disk type of infrastructure.
I think that would be worth discussing.
Okay.
Yes. There have been several discussions, and I'm going back to the progress, but unless you think we're going off topic too much.
I think when it comes to this, so we have
10:30 now.
Okay, we can take this offline.
I think we should take it
off. We should take it off to London, right. Some else place.
Yeah.
Because if we have more things on stable, on this kernel, the CI, we could discuss it. We should have some time for it also, I think.
I have one more issue that is kernel related. There are currently two packages in the new queue. One is PCMCIA modules 2.4. The other is the 2.4 S390 kernel. They should really be in state of proposed updates, but because those packages have not been updated since the SARS release in unstable, they have to go through unstable and trickle down to.
Are there still in UQ? There's at least a lot of packages from the new queue that were there due to a Lisa bug.
Well,
basically, what's happening is if you upload the queue, you upload proposed updates or proposed updates, it detects that this version is stable, is the same as in testing. It just gives a warning that says, oh, I'm also putting that into testing proposed updates now. At least the release files from you said, oh, there's a warning, it's probably an error, and just said no. Which was then afterwards fixed, but.
Yeah, I still have them here. Endless record modules I386 and kernel image 2.4, 27, S390, targeted proposed updates.
So,
I make sure what needs to be done. Ah yeah, say a target proposed update, but if the same version is in SARS and in testing, or is SARS and Edge and unstable, if it's targeted proposed update, it might still go to everything. I'll check it. But actually in the changes file, make sure that we get some results get back to you or to go back to line.
But it still means, I guess, that there should be an upload to unstable as well.
Or what if we remove those packages from unstable? Is that would that work?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. And
it sounds like that's what you're
saying. And basically, I think for Edge, it's a question if we still need 2.4 kernels or not.
Yeah. Well, so far I believe it's no. I don't think anybody's come back and said yes. We will.
But
I'm willing to do all the security support for 2.4. So nobody has said that. So I think they're going to be gone.
I have suggested to the release managers fairly recently to make a hard decision on that and start acting on it very soon, because that will make things clear for everybody, packager that's involved that still has 2.4 related packages, driver modules.
Okay, I think I'll make sure that we have a decision before we do our talk on Thursday.
Yeah, Holger is the person here that's been most pushing to continue with him.
Yes,
I think he's okay with him going away.
But probably we should finish off, perhaps we just make a meeting with Holger and perhaps you and you or so and discuss better what we do.
Yeah. Joey has been advocating keeping him as well, but he's not really offered to do the help.
Right.
So. Yeah, I will check and we'll do a decision on that, yes.
Well, I think our what we decided was that there's no reason to preclude users from running 2.4.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, doing their own two-point maintenance.
Yeah.
You don't want to break that.
I think that has already been decided. The user should be able to work with 2.4.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We have discussed this fairly briefly yesterday during the BI involved as well. I think the remark that ended was, well, people can always download 2.4 from kernel headquarters and build it from there.
Yeah, as long as it works with GDAM.
Are we going to produce 2.4 in Flash Media or not? Because I haven't changed that.
If there is no 2.4 kernel in Edge, then we won't, obviously.
Exactly. So I have machines that are currently installed in 2.6.
Have you been working on getting the bugs fixed in 2.6.8 in 2.6 kernels? Because there must be a reason why you're still running 2.4. That must be because the 2.6 kernels don't work for you.
They work for me after regional compilation, so the installation doesn't work.
Okay.
I don't know how to fix that. Because I haven't quite narrowed down the tweak in the many changes that I did. I will do a blind search.
Well, that's something to work on then.
It is. It is something to work on, I know.
No.
But it's also something that it works the way I do it, so I have no great pressure to fix it. But if 2.4 is going away, I'll have to fix it.
In that respect, the AI can only support what the distribution supports, so
is someone actually going to actively check that things do work if you install a 2.4 kernel?
Basically,
dependencies on UDEV and so on. And
basically, we've had installer images with 2.6.14 to 16 for the past half year.
Yeah.
So if people haven't been trying them for their hardware,
what I mean is, you said you want it to be supported, that users can download 2.4 themselves.
After installing the 2.6.
So is someone checking that this does work, despite the
differences? You can download and compile
2.2
kernels on SID, and they will install, and if you got all...
But do you end up removing half the distribution from SID?
You can build and run 2.2 kernels as long as you've got hardware support on SID.
And you have to realize
the kernel package, the main KPKJ, still supports 2.2, and I tested it in March. So as of March,
I wasn't really worried about low-level stuff, but it's just if there's assumptions in like GNOME and so on.
Basically, I think you're lying, but I would say a typical QA task that we need. Yes, I think we should note that there's an open issue. How can we test it? But it's not too important either.
Yeah.
It's not really an issue because so far we have had 2.4 support in the store and we have tested that you end up with working installation. So there's no real problem. The only thing a user has to realize is that if he does it, UDEV won't run anymore. So he will need some other form of hardware detection installed. So he will need to install either Discover or...
Yeah, maybe it's something that should just be in the release notes.
Definitely.
Somewhere
just file a bucket for it.
We definitely need help for this release with the release notes because it's going to be quite a complex story for users.
One thing about what you're saying, Naj, while you can still build and compile and install and put the 2.2 kernel, glibc has moved to 2.4 as the minimum version, so you're not going to be able to run many binaries on the system. And as time goes forward, you'll be able to run pretty much nothing.
In fact, I talked to Gotu Masaveri a couple weeks ago, joined the glibc maintainers, and he's saying that the current upstream glibc has dropped to 2.2 support or 2.4 support
running. Well, I'm
so
I was testing on an potato machine.
Okay.
But yeah, it was built on a SID machine.
Yeah, but I think
rebooted into the potato.
I think the glibc SID issue is really something that will break 2.4 support sooner or later. I don't expect it will break for Edge, but only for Edge plus 1.
Yeah, when I was talking to him, his concern was he would really like to update for Edge, but it doesn't sound like we'll be able to.
If I remember correctly, and the total was offered to maintain records of MPPL for support.
That would be great. Then we can keep it up.
Okay.
But of course, it will be a data which just stop 2.4 support. Like, I don't think that the support running won't see something current on SIP anymore. Yes, so.
The main impact of dropping 2.4 will probably be for M68K.
Then we still have even 2.2 kernels in the archive.
Yes. So they may have to either drop some sub-architectures, or they will have to work very hard to get remaining issues resolved. I think all other architectures are about ready to make the switch to 2.6.
Or have done it.
Or have already done it. The only main ones are the NIPSA, architectures, and M68K.
As a step, a kernel step now, I don't really care very much about M68K. I think it's not really scary anyways.
No. And SV90, but SV90 is also almost ready to switch.
Oh, okay.
In the install.
Yes, it's also not really candidate. But I hope that this changes, or I have good hope that this changes. That with this M68K, I currently don't see a threat.
Well, it's important for the installer anyway. For the installer, they have to make the switch before the release if they want to be able to do anything.
Yeah. So. We will see. So another thing that we need to discuss about stable point releases or stable release management now. Of course, for the large edge releasing, we have to talk, last discussion on Thursday. I made sure that we have a lot of discussion time. So, something you want to about stable point releases?
Well, are there any questions or concerns about the possible like edge and a half type kernel update? Does anybody? I mean, there'll be a lot of technical issues to do it later.
Can you elucidate what do you mean by edge and a half kernel update?
Well, we're just calling it, we're just making that term up. But what we mean is a stable kernel update that takes us from, say, 2.6.16 to whatever is current halfway between edge and edge plus one.
I thought we were not on a supporting thing, but 2.6.16.
That's what we're discussing. At the time of release, we won't.
But post that, we might move off 2.6.16?
No, in addition to 2.6.16, add another one.
Well, it depends a bit on where 2.6.16 is going, I think. If 2.6.16 gets all the relevant backports, then you could just do a 2.6.16 upgrade.
Yeah,
yes,
that's
essentially the right? I think it also depends on the way the updates are done. Because Adrian says that he doesn't really mind about API compatibility, which is something well, I'm not too happy about.
Why? If there's a security update.
Yeah, if it's required, yes. Because well, he doesn't mind to break existing kernel modules for new features. That's something else than a security update. Security, yes, definitely. And probably is the binary only drivers like, let's say, something like VMware still works even after the API change. But if you say, maybe you're just changing the kernel interface because it looks better that way, or it's easier to backport drivers, then that might not be the case. But of course, that's now not really something decided. It's just a case that might happen. And I think we just need to review the changes there, so yeah, we are there, and then we can say, okay, is the change okay or not? And then we can say, do we rather need another kernel or not?
Yeah.
Well, I think the SE Linux constituency representative, we would like to have 2.6.18. Because there are changes that are scheduled going forward, 17 and 18, that will make it possible to deploy the build in really hardcore security environments, multi-level security changes and so on. So there is at least one constituency that would like to have support for the latest kernel out there from the Debian kernel. I don't know how it impacted the Debian installer except for maybe H++.
Well, the way that I get in the story is that if we have to wait until 2.6.18, then we cannot.
No, you. This is. I'm not going to push for that for Edge. Because we don't have the support for that kind of security in Debian yet, anyway. So So this is for X plus 1, but he asked about if you're going to do something about X and a half. Yes, there is at least one set of people who would love to have the
If you don't have the rest of the support in that year in stable at that time, then do you, is, does it make sense to have to
I don't want to push it for edge because I want to freeze things by end of June. So I don't think I can do it between here and end of June. Between now and December, the packages that I'm talking about that I have to update, they won't be frozen until late, late in the fall. So
late in the fall?
What I'm talking about
in December.
So, the modeling part of base will be frozen something in somewhere in July, August. And all packages will be frozen mid of October.
The way I see the timeline is I want to get the basic functionality that is needed for the app installer. I want it working at the end of June.
Yes.
I wouldn't have the multi-level security working until then, so it's not going to be in Debian installer.
So when will you have that?
I think I will have that working, I hope, by July or August time frame.
Yeah, but my understanding currently is that these are a little optional part. From the archive point of view, are something like optional or extra. So you could ask them very late, and if they work, it's good. Mm-hmm. And if not, it's not really problem. It doesn't break the system.
And it won't be a bug fix.
It will be a bug fix. And then also, if you say, okay, we need to update the SA Linux policy because this and that is broken, it might possibly should even do it in the point release later. Because they are not in the core part of the system.
No, my question was, if it's going to be after December, there's no point in discussing
It's not going to be after December, because 2618, I hope, will be out before December.
Yeah, but the kernel for Edge will be, needs to be not only decided, but installed mid of July, because if you want to make a DI release candidate, just probably say DI release for Edge in the beginning of August, there's not much point in doing it later.
Yeah. No, that's right. Although, given the schedule, I think we can do one or maybe even two 2.6.16 updates after that. Because rebuilds of the eye from that kernel are much easier now that we don't have to wait for the individual builds of the kernels. We just have to coordinate with porters to do the unit builds quickly, and I think we do have the
operation. Is that true for all kernel updates or only for updates in one kernel series like 2.6.16?
Yes, the last.
Okay.
Can I explain a little bit more about what I think the misunderstanding given us? Even though the official kernel will be 2.6.16 for Edge, Debian installer will be 2.6.16. As well. 2.6.18 will be out before we release Edge. I read our timeline and my feeling is after reading LTML. If 2.6.18 is out, the extra and the optional packages that support SE Linux in Edge will support 2.6.18.
Well, I understand that. Yeah.
So, which is why if the kernel team after we release Edge officially releases 2.6.18, then the security users don't have to go off on their own and compile their own kernels. So that's what I was trying to.
Okay. So I was just notified now by the heads of this event that I should just come to an end soon. I also think we have done lots of important stuff, so it was mostly about the kernel, but obviously the other thing was really interesting to most of the users also. Otherwise, I would just say thank you to you all.
We will need to talk about a new kernel because it does have implications for the installer.
Certainly, I haven't even talked to the kernel. This was late last night when we talked about it. The kernel team is not in agreement
okay.
to do it.
Because you would also need to see, okay, what are your meta packages going to refer to? Are they going to refer to 2.6.16 or 2.6.18?
Yep.
Because otherwise, the installer installs the meta packages, so the user will end up with whatever they point to.
We had some discussion.
One question for us about that. Would it be possible to make, if we do a newer kernel, we need to build the installer also to get used to the kernel to installation? So if we do that, could we say, please don't install this meta package, but another meta package? Or would it be too much?
No, before? You have to, basically, if you want something else than what the current meta package points to, you have to do a medium or low priority install. So you have to do an extra installer.
But if you rebuild the installer, could we change it so we can install another meta package? Or is it too much work?
Depends on the naming of the meta package.
What else means?
Something I was thinking.
It's not very nice.
Something I was thinking about was the way we do like 2.6 and 2.4 today. That we, when we roll DI, if we do this in the future.
Well, the problem is that the kernel major is not going to change, and we currently use the kernel major to decide on the meta package.
I suspect that if we do this, the kernel major would change, or the ABI would change. Oh, I see what you're saying, kernel 2.6.
What we decided to make a meta package that just tells, okay, this is now the current kernel edge, or the current kernel edge plus, four, edge plus a half, and this package is replaced by the additional package after the edge plus one release, so that users will get upgrade the kernel with the next disk upgrade after edge.
But in the old installer, the default installer was a 2.4 kernel, but if we didn't have you want the 2.6.8.
But they had separate majors, so they had, that was DI. So
we based that decision on majors. We would do a consistent installation. If you boot with 2.4, we would install 2.4. If you boot 2.6, you would install 2.6.
Okay.
To extend that to a minor, it's going to break things horribly, especially in stable, because there are just too many updates of miners.
Are you looking? Are you wedded to that a digit dot digit, or can we have a better package called install for edge?
That's
a better one, because I have to just say kernel 2.6 edge.
No, just say Linux image edge.
Whatever. I don't mind about names as long as it's useful.
We are of course willing to think about it, but it's not something I can just.
The question was just, is it easy to say, well, it's 5 minutes time? We could say, but if it's more, then of course we have to discuss first. That's
what we
discussed
first.
Okay, but then I think we should now finish with that, because I also see more and more signs and I get nervous. So we finish. Thank you all for coming. It was a good discussion we had. And yeah, let's work on it.
Okay.